Hello everybody, Jimmy is Promo here, back again with another awesome video. And today, I'm pretty excited and stoked to show you that Samsung has put an update for the disabling of the Bixby button. Now, the cool thing about this one is not just the simple fact that it is now disabled if you were to press the button, but it's what makes me more excited is the fact that you can probably see some customizations coming with this button coming up in the near future. So let me explain this just a little bit more a little bit later on in the video. Let's first off move over into Bixby Home, and I'm going to show you how you'll be able to turn this off. So on the very top up here, if you're to hover, you can see where it says Bixby key setting. And when you click on the Bixby key setting, this is your option to toggle off the Bixby key. So now what'll happen is if I was to go inside of there and if I was to hit the Bixby button, it is now not responding to the press, but it is going to respond when I was to press and hold on the Bixby button. So then this way I can still dictate what I want my phone to do without getting into the device. So let's say maybe I wanted to change the brightness. Change brightness to 65%. And now let's move over into back into the home screen settings. I want to show you where the other location is that you can turn this on or turn it off. So if you hover your S Pen over the very top right hand side where it says more options, once you click on more options, then you'll hit on settings. And then you'll scroll down, and this is where you see the option here for Bixby key. And these are the two different options you have at this moment in time. And I got a feeling there will actually be more that'll follow after this. So right now, if you were to just only press the Bixby button, this right now will do nothing. But if you're to still press and hold, it gives you the opportunity to still speak to Bixby. And then on the very top, you have the option here where it is from the original way, which is you press to open Bixby Home. And then if you were to press and hold, it is able to open Bixby Voice. Now, I'm going to move it down over into the open and do nothing. But what I want to show off is down here. Just imagine the fact that Samsung's able to add more customizations to this. And the reason why I state that is because when you get down into something that you press, there's so many different ways you'd be able to do tapping and pressing and combinations. So as example, what I'm trying to mean by this is right now, if I was to go in and press on that power key, it turns the screen off. If I was to go back in there and I was to press the power key again, it's going to turn the phone back on. But what happens when you double press on that power button? This is where it comes into the quick camera launch. And there you can see my brand new camera that I'm shooting with today. And so that right there kind of makes me a little excited, because then this way I got a feeling that they're going to add in the ability to do a little bit more with this Bixby button. You know, maybe what they'll do is they can make it to where it'll do absolutely nothing entirely, where it doesn't even open up Bixby Voice, but I doubt that's going to happen. More than likely, they might have an opportunity where if you were to double press on their with no pressing and holding, just a double press, maybe that'll pop up maybe Bixby Vision. Maybe you can double tap this button over here or double press it and it'll open up some other thing, maybe Translate, you know, pretty much almost anything that is brand new on the Galaxy Note 8. So I can rant on and on about what they could use this Bixby button for the double press, but you kind of get the idea. That is why I'm excited for this update. It paves the way for future improvements and more ability of what they can do if they were to double press with the Bixby button. So Samsung, if you're watching this, anybody who's part of product, you know, development or application changing or whatever the case may be, here we are today crying out for help and love if you guys are able to add in the double press of a Bixby button to let us customize what we want it to open of your particular applications that is preloaded on the Galaxy Note 8. So if you guys are also a little interested in the pencil that I'm using, this is going to be the very next video that will be uploaded very soon. This right here is a brand new digital S Pen. It's from Staedtler Digital. And so this one right here, the cool thing about it is that even though it doesn't have a button, and the very rear of it does not operate like an eraser, but the cool thing about it is that it looks and feels just like a normal pencil. But for some reason, I just love putting this thing, you know, right above and behind the ear or in the pocket, just pulling it out and then actually using it with the Galaxy Note 8. So, and also the great thing about it is that this is usually cheaper than the normal S Pen that'll go inside of your Galaxy Note 8. So this right here will be an upcoming video. Also, if there's anything in this video that you guys like, to make sure you guys give this thing a thumbs up. Also too, if there's anything that you guys have learned and it's brand new, make sure you guys go below the video and hit on subscribe, or hit on the subscribe circle on the very bottom left hand side. And be sure to share this video with any type of social media. And I'll see you guys later.